please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Welcome back. You're watching Young Turks. On the show today, we're putting the spotlight on digital media companies. Here's the next one. Founded in 2013, ScoopWhoop Media is today one of India's largest independent digital content startups. The mother brand runs three publications, ScoopWhoop.com, vagabomb.com and gazabpost.com. And almost all the content produced is targeted at the Indian millennial. Overall, the team publishes 3,000 stories and 300 videos every month with 30 million unique users. Let's take a look at their story.
Satvik and Rishi were my classmates at IMC. And we weren't that great friends in IMC, to be honest. We knew each other. Post Satvik and Rishi both went on into the digital media sphere. They joined web as a copywriter.
So one thing led to the other, and I still remember it was a long weekend. So over Friday, Saturday and Sunday, we created a site. We made it live and we started writing articles. We thought that how difficult can it be to write a listicle. And we wrote one article and within 12 hours, it sort of hit 2 million views.
So the first article that went viral for us was if Game of Thrones was made in India, then which Indian actor would play which character. And it was just like a fun article.
I went to my advertising agency and one of my colleagues is like, dude, have you read this? And I'm like, what? And when I looked, it was the ScoopWhoop link. And I had a little smile to myself and I was like, oh, nice. I played along. But yeah, that's the time when I realized that we were onto something big.
And our CEO basically got wind of the fact that this is something that is happening right under his nose. And he was gracious enough to sort of, instead of firing us, he basically not only encouraged us to pursue this, but he also came in as our first angel investor.
The team says that kind of support from the get-go was crucial to convert their side project into their labor of love. Apart from Denso Web Chutney's founder and CEO Siddharth Rao, the team managed to rope in Haresh Chawla, former CEO of Network 18, in 2013 to kickstart ScoopWhoop. A few months down the line, the brand managed to woo Bharti SoftBank and Kalari Capital, taking the total funding to $6 million to date.
Internet is the same. And the internet audience is the same, right? Whether you look at US, India, Europe, or even some of the emerging markets like Africa. What an average teenager in a US, in a city in US would like to read and consume. Things aren't very different for an Indian teenager in India. Indian teenager sitting out of Delhi. What is different is their consumption behavior and the consumption patterns.
Soon after starting this pattern, the team realized that all brands are chasing one target group, the Indian millennials who are either consumers today or will become in the future. Having cracked the viral model, ScoopWhoop began pouring into genres like lifestyle, humor, sports, travel, food, technology, both in the form of texts and in-house video production.
We used to do women-centric stories under ScoopWhoop. But then, as a brand, we felt conscious enough to start a women's portal. And that's when we decided that we'll start Vagabomb, which will be, the core of it would be women. Then we also realized that the regional audience is a key audience, you know. Like, reaching them, reaching to the audience is really important. And that's why we decided we'll do gazabpost. Because a lot of stories that ScoopWhoop was doing was not reaching them. So we needed another a pillar to get to people, and that was gazabpost, which was for the Hindi audience.
But not all experiments have seen success. In November last year, ScoopWhoop gave big slips to more than a dozen employees and shut down its news coverage operations.
You know, trial and error is going to be the part and parcel of any startup, especially a startup that is as young as us. You know, one knows about BuzzFeed and Vice and Vox going through this thing, but even in India, Hindustan Times and an ABP also went through this churn in 2017.
If you look at the new media space, we're clearly the number one when it comes to size and the number of users that we reach out to. But having said that, I personally believe that this is not a winner-takes-it-all space. But at the same time, I also believe that there'll be limited seats on the table, right? There'll be top five or six new media companies that are going to take 70-80% of the branded content advertising dollars that are going to be spent in this space. We just have to try hard enough to be one of them. But the real competition is from the Facebook and the Googles of the world, right? I think getting audience, getting traction is one part of the problem, and I think that we've solved very well over the last 3 years. But if you look at today, 90% of the advertising dollars, digital advertising spends, go on Facebook and YouTube and Googles of the world. I think the idea would be, or the challenge would be, that how do you sort of get brands to spend more on your platform?
But unfortunately for ScoopWhoop, 2017 was not just about downsizing. The publication was in news when one of the founding member was booked for sexual harassment by a former employee. This highlighted once again how it is imperative for the startup community to address this issue in a provocative manner, and it led us to ask, how does one build a healthy work culture, and if it raised a red flag amongst investors?
If you look at ScoopWhoop, almost 60% of the staff are women. As a company, I think the first step that we took was being very transparent with our employees and with the team in general. At the same time, what we've also ensured is that there are regular workshops that are done within the company to sort of sensitize people around workplace discrimination and sort of just gender balance.
With a team of 120 people and offices in Delhi, Mumbai and Bangalore, ScoopWhoop is looking to hit 120 crores in revenue by 2020. How? Well, going forward, the plan is to double down on vernacular content and video, both fiction and non-fiction, to achieve this target.
Saptik, Rishi and Sriparna here is wishing you the very best for 2018, and welcome to the Young Turks community.